Hey guys, welcome to my channel Backpack Story and I am Pooja. Hope you have enjoyed our promo video to West Sikkim and waiting for the next video. So let's not waste any more time and dive into the videos.
This was my first trek, which I have always wanted to take part in. Not because every single person may want to witness some real beauty of nature, but because such thing motivates me in a way to learn new things in life, like how to survive in a place where no facilities are available for the entire route. And last but not the least, it allows you to challenge yourself with one and only yourself, to get to know your strength and your abilities. And things I got to learn from this trek is not only physical strength, but mental strength and self-confidence is also required equally in such sport. We started our journey on 26th March 2021 from Sialdah Station along with 16 team members by Darjeeling Mail at 10 pm. On that night, none of us slept until 4 am as all of us were so excited about fantasizing the trek. We reached NGP station at around 8 am on 27th March. Our cab started from NGP station at around 9:30 am towards Bari, which was the last reachable road by any convince to start the trek. We took our first break at Siliguri for breakfast, as it was supposed to be a long journey till Bari via cab. We had roti, paratha and sabji on our breakfast at a local shop. After having breakfast, we started moving towards Bharing. At around 2 pm, we reached to Jhortang and took a break to get some required stuff from Jhortang market. After reaching Bharing, we realized that the weather was little bit cold. The temperature was supposed to go down to 6 degrees at night and in the morning something between 10 to 12 degrees. And then we started to walk through the forest. As it was the very first trek for some of us, so at the very starting of the trek, we faced some difficulties through the trek. It took approx 2.5 hours for us to reach our first destination, which was Gorkhi. In the evening, the view of Gorkhi was so beautiful that cannot be described in words, as the place was surrounded by pine trees, hills and forest all around. We could still hear sweet and calming sound of the rivers and the sweet chirping of birds. Small colorful flowers surrounding the road was looking like a perfect canvas, which was perfectly drawn by any artist. Everyone woke up at around 6 am to freshen up, as all of us wanted to enjoy the peace and the morning beauty of the village. We finished our breakfast and left for Samandin village. That day, we were not carrying our most of the luggages, as it was a small preparation for the final trek. The distance between Gorkhi and Samandin village is around 45 minutes maximum. We had to go all the way uphill to reach the village. The road to reach Samandin was little bit tough, as it was through the jungle and the hills, but all of us did it so well with the encouragement of the entire team, and we finally reached to Samandin. We found the main attraction during the season, which is rhododendron flower. It took around 45 minutes for us to reach the village. There were maximum 20 to 25 families and their beautiful houses, completely surrounded by pine trees, hills and colorful small flowers leading us through the road. We took a walk through the village and the pine forest. The small trees around the village with white flowers and the sun rays through it were so eye-calming. We took some group photos there to capture the moment and to capture Mother Nature in a frame. started to walk back through our homestay as we wanted to visit the tower on the top of the Gorkhe village to enjoy the full mesmerizing view before sunset. At around 5 p.m., we started walking towards the tower. It was not so far from the village, but the road was a little tricky and rough, as it was uphill all the way. It took 30 minutes for us to reach the place. After reaching there, we enjoyed the full view of the forest, the beauty of nature, and especially the sunset. It was our last day at Gorkhe, so we had planned for a bonfire and chicken barbecue. So without delaying further, we started getting back to our homestay. We received our oats, marinated chicken and other useful things from the homestay. Temperature was at 6 degrees and the blowing air was very cold. We relaxed there for a while and enjoyed the tasty barbecue under the open skies surrounded by the beauty of nature. On that last day, some of us woke up early at around 5 a.m. and decided to take a short walk around the village for the last time. Weather was cold, but nothing could stop us from that moment to leave. After spending some quality time with nature and its beauty, we got our backpacks ready, as it was the final trek, and the trek was about 15 km, totally up and downhill through the forest and rough roads. We had to cross Samandin village to reach Srikhola. We found fresh scratch mark made by a bear on a pine tree, and that was another new experience for a new trekker like me. It was a long trek, so we carried dry foods and lots of water with us. We crossed jungles, water streams, rough roads, and we finally reached to Dammam. And guess what? Another pleasing and eye-calming view of the location. We rested for a while and had our lunch at a local hotel available there. As it was supposed to be rain heavily, so without wasting time, we finished our lunch and left by 1:45 p.m. At around 3 p.m., we reached to Dhotre village, and we had to walk for another 2 hours approximately to reach Srikhola. The hard bricks all over the road and the roughness made the walk a little more tougher. Still, it could not stop us from reaching us our final destination. We reached at Srikhola by 4:45 p.m. There was a hanging bridge that connected two hills over a river. Sikkim's religious flags was all over the bridge. Every one of us took a peaceful bath and rested for a while, enjoying the beautiful nature and the lovely weather. As we finally reached to our last destination, after many challenges came through the roads, the excitement was on another level for us. We had to spend the last night at a local homestay, as our trek ends here at Srikhola. We got freshened up and enjoyed that amazing weather. The silence, the beauty was mesmerizing, breathtaking and peaceful. We woke up at 5 a.m. and took a last short walk to the nearby river. Our cab from Srikhola to NGP, which was pre-booked and scheduled for 9 a.m. What I have learned from my first trek is, you just need to be prepared for the upcoming challenges through the life and have to be confident of what you decide to do. And you never know what is going to amaze you throughout your life after a hustle.
Last but not the least, I would like to thank each and every member of my team, because without them, the trek would have not been completed so nicely. And I'm looking further to join them for next trips coming in future. And if you have liked our video, just don't forget to subscribe us, like us and comment us. Help us to grow.